I have implemented in printing at PwC. We have close to 50, 55 imprinting reports that we roll out on daily, monthly, weekly basis. So, how many have you heard about imprinting? And is anybody of you already working on imprinting?
Okay.
So, coming on to today's aim is to familiarize you with imprinting. What are the terminologies that are used in imprinting? What imprinting does? Why do we prefer imprinting? What are the benefits of imprinting? And what are the different components? And later on in the presentation, we will be talking about a case study of implementation of imprinting at a particular client. And I will be walking you through the typical stages of development on an imprinting project. Okay, so I'll just move on. What is imprinting? Imprinting takes the reports out of the click dashboards that you develop. It may be ClickView, it may be ClickSense, and then it pulls out the objects, paste them into a specific or you can say static format that you have developed, and then it sends that report to a specified user on a specified time. It creates very good looking reports. So in later on, I will be showing you a couple of examples of the reports that have been generated through imprinting, and you will see the detailing that can be done through imprinting. And that is why it is one of the industry leaders in reporting, in BI reporting. It also ensures the right people get the right report. And not only through mailers, users can get the reports whenever they want through the on-demand feature that is present on the imprinting. And what imprinting does is it reduces a lot of redundant time of the company, because earlier what used to be there, people used to hire a specific reporting team. Those people would go to the dashboards, download the reports, then create specific charts, paste them in a format, specific format specified by the company, and then send it to all the stakeholders. Now, that time has completely been reduced, and imprinting is doing all that for you. So it is a very handy tool to learn, and it is in high demand. So I would encourage you to really go after it and learn it, because it is not that difficult to learn, but once you learn it's a very handy skill. Coming on to the role of imprinting in the business. So here in this graphic, you can see three circles. The innermost circle is of business analyst. These people sit at the core of the business. These people mostly interrogate the data, slice and dice the data, and know everything that data can do. Okay. Then we have the circle of the information explorers. These people are consuming pre-built applications and are adding something to the already created applications, and are using the self-service BI practices as well. And the outermost circle is the passive consumers. So this is the kind of the target audience for the imprinting, because these people aren't using BI tools all by themselves. So these people need a push to use the BI applications. So we send the imprinting to these people. So imprinting is highly targeted. You only get the data that you want. And what it does is it creates a thirst in the mind of user to get more and more data. And then it pushes the passive users towards the inside circles, towards the information explorers and the business analysts. So here the imprinting plays a really, driving factor in the data journey of your organization, because it can create a thirst for the data and inform decisions in the users who are currently not using BI at all. So imprinting adds a real value to ClickView solution by exposing its output discovery to a broader audience, boosting adoption and collaborating and promoting operational effectiveness. So now in this slide, we have complete ClickSense Enterprise bouquet. So we'll just see where Click Imprinting sits in the entire bouquet of services that is provided by Click. So on the leftmost panel here, it is the self-service data visualization or the ClickSense, where user can drag and drop and build their own charts. The guided analytics part is the ClickView part, and it is centrally deployed. Users do not have a much of a say in it because they can not really interact with the UI. They cannot build it by themselves. And the third and the fourth panel is Click Analytics platform. So Click Analytics platform takes the data out of ClickSense and takes the objects, creating mashups, web pages, and other environments for the users to get the data from. And on the rightmost panel here, we have Click Imprinting. So Imprinting is all about reporting and collaborating, and it is managed report distribution across the enterprise. Now the advantage in Imprinting. So Imprinting is the next generation reporting distribution solution for ClickSense and ClickView, helping organization to spread knowledge and insight. So one of the most, one of the best advantages of Imprinting is it has Microsoft Office reporting and integration. So whatever you can do in Microsoft Office, be it Excel, be it Word, be it PDFs, or be it PPTs, you can develop the same report in Imprinting. So that is a huge boon, because most of the reporting in companies is being done through Microsoft Office. Then for users who need highly precise reports, users such as marketing users, or some reports that are being created for the customers, then you can go for Pixel Perfect reports. They are very high quality PDF reports. Then you can have web reports based on HTML. So you will need a little bit of HTML, and rest of the coding will be done itself by the system. You'll just need to drag and drop some objects onto your sheet, and system will take care of the HTML code itself. And if you need to create really precise reports in HTML, then you need to know the language as well. And another feature of HTML reports is there are many kinds of users in the organization. Some users do not download the report from the mail and view it. So for those users, you will need to embed the report within the mail body. So if I give good two insights within the mail body, so I give something for the user to go and download the report and see the numbers in detail. So that can be done through Imprinting as well. So I'll just give the top line, the revenue, net margin, gross margin of a particular user within the email body using this, and then he would want to download the report and see the details of what all transactions I have done to get to this revenue or net margin or gross margin or whatever. Another great advantage is a multi-developer environment. So earlier we didn't have a multi-developer environment, and it was fixed to a machine. But now that Imprinting 17 has moved to web portal, so we have a multi-developer environment in place. The use that is at the core of Imprinting is sending the right reports to the right people. So I have been told that it is mostly a Click pool that I am interacting with today. So you people may be knowing about section access, right? So what section access does is it restricts the access of a user to a particular region or a particular line of business, because you cannot show everything to every user. So whenever you are reporting, you will need this feature to send the particular report to a particular user. If a user is working in region A, you'll want the data of region A to go to the user and not the region B. So that can be achieved using this reporting. Secondly, you can schedule reports. These are very targeted and very secure. So you don't need to worry about the security. Then you have a newsstand subscription portal. What is a newsstand? Newsstand is a feature where you can go to an online portal and subscribe to specific reports that you want. And printing would be running in the background and providing, keeping all the reports on the newsstand portal updated. And users without the email configured can go to this newsstand portal, subscribe to the reports, and get access to the data. Now, collaborative analytics for everyone. So, for the big organizations, what we have is we can break down in printing on multi-threaded systems. So, it is now scalable. All the load is not on a single system. And this time they have enhanced the role-based security, and the overall reporting efficiency and value has been increased. So this is a screenshot of newsstand, what a typical newsstand looks like. You can see you can select the report which you want to download and the time period for the report. It may have been published yesterday, today, or whenever. So you have all the flexibility of starred reports. You can subscribe report, put a star on them. You can categorize, you can filter reports. So it is a very interactive UI that they have developed. Now, summing up the features of InPrinting. So it has a very responsive web interface for administrative tasks and report design, a centralized distribution system that simplifies report generation and distribution. Users can access, subscribe, and complete set of reports, and you can share knowledge within your organization. And below here, it is some of the important points that I have already discussed with you. Now, InPrinting deployment. So whenever you will be getting a project for InPrinting, there are certain tools or certain softwares within InPrinting that you will need to learn and get familiarized to. So for the introduction part of it, I'm just telling about what a particular tool does. And then in later part of this series, we'll walk you through all these tools, and you will know how to use these tools and perform these specific tasks. So just lend me your ears and let me just introduce you to the tools. So first is Click InPrinting Server. Click InPrinting Server is the central node. It has a scheduler, a web engine, and a repository. The server manages administration, security, and all the other side tasks. It also coordinates multi-reporting engines installed on different nodes and distribution of workload. So what is Click InPrinting Server? Whenever you will be deploying InPrinting, you can schedule the frequency of your report. You can import the recipients, and you can administer whether your InPrinting is going directly or not through this InPrinting Server. Then the second part is InPrinting Designer. You will be developing your reports within this designer. So you will have an option to choose the dashboard of ClickView or ClickSense that needs to be connected to your report that has all your data. Then you will have specific formats within that. You can choose from Excel, PDF, Pixel Perfect report, HTML report, Word report. And then you can start building your design in this. And the Click InPrinting engine. The engine is the backend of all the InPrinting. Whenever it sees that a schedule has come up, it will automatically open that dashboard and start generating reports, filtering out the data itself, creating all the reports for all the users. Let's say you have 100 users, then it will create 100 reports at the backend and then start mailing those reports. So I had earlier talked about some of the samples of InPrinting. So on the left, you have a Word sample and it can also be considered as a PDF sample. So you can see the details that go through, and on the right there is a PPT sample. So you can see the detailing is very good. You cannot make out if a human has made it or it has been made through imprinting. You can specify your charts, you can specify some text objects, you can specify images according to some rule. So this all can be achieved through imprinting. So these are beautiful looking reports that the users get. Now, coming on to imprinting 16 versus 17. For the scope of this session, this should be looked as a list of product capabilities for imprinting. Later, when we will discuss the imprinting 16 and 17 more deeply, then you will understand the telling differences and how some of the challenges have been overcome in imprinting 17. So I have highlighted some of the good features that have come up. So the online subscription hub, I have already talked about this. Pixel Perfect in web reporting. This is a very precise and very beautiful reporting tool. Then the complete web-based architecture has radically changed the perception of users towards the imprinting. It is very user-friendly. And then the introduction of role-based security has, you know, really eased the way you provide access or provide reports to your users. You can basically use the section access built in the application to sort the data out and filter the data out. And the multi-developer environment is also a good boost, because whenever there are multiple users, now there are no clashes and they can work simultaneously. So I'll just play a small click imprinting product tour for you. It has all the highlights of whatever I have been talking about for past 10-15 minutes. So just watch it.
Click Imprinting is Click's next generation enterprise class reporting and distribution solution for ClickSense and ClickView. It's a server-based application that enables you to create, manage, and distribute all of your reporting projects. Click Imprinting enables organizations to easily create great-looking reports using data and analytics from ClickSense and ClickView. Create reports quickly in formats such as PowerPoint, Excel, and Word, leveraging existing skills in your organization. Drag and drop simplicity allows for easy creation of office documents with tables, charts, and objects from one or more ClickSense or ClickView apps. Office templates can be edited using office formatting options. The internal HTML editor can be used to create reports for web publications and emails. Create highly polished reports through the built-in Pixel Perfect editor. Advanced customization features such as banding, scripting, and advanced formatting and graphics allow for high-quality custom reports. Centrally schedule, generate, and deliver reports to a variety of recipients with filtered information customized to each user. Automatically deliver reports through email or distribute to your corporate directories. You can also publish your reports on the Newsstand web portal. In the Newsstand, users can view, download, and subscribe to available reports or schedule custom updates in a user-friendly web interface. You can now publish both ClickView and ClickSense reports directly to the ClickSense Hub, providing users a single destination for all their analytics and reporting needs. Users can also directly print and export analytics, sheets, and stories from ClickSense and request on-demand reports from ClickView. You can also generate on-demand reports in ClickSense using the on-demand reporting extension. Click Imprinting features enterprise scalability and security that supports the demands of large enterprises, you need greater report distribution capacity, you can easily scale by adding more reporting engines. Click Everything manages load balancing across servers and the prioritization of publishing tasks based on your needs. Security profiles can be created and assigned to users, so they are allowed to build and view only within appropriate environments. Click Emprinting ensures a high level of security. User authentication, authorization, and auditing are built-in capabilities throughout the application. With Click Emprinting, Click can serve as a single solution for both interactive analytics and reporting, allowing organizations to retire legacy BI systems and encourage recipients to adopt interactive analytics to see the whole story in their data.
So, coming on to some of our clients, so these are some of the clients that we are currently catering to. And I have been working closely with PwC. And in next few slides, we will be talking about.
Okay, Abhishek.
Yes, ma'am.
Before you get into the use case, there are few questions you need to address.
Sure.
Chavi Kudana has a question. Can we create a single report from two or three applications?
Yes, you can.
Okay.
So there is an option
Chavi,
to build.
Got the answer?
So there is an option to build connections. So you can build a connection to multiple applications at the same time, and then you can use the number from different applications into your report.
Okay, sir. Got it.
So, thank you. Thank you, Chavi. Vijendra has a question. Number of reports from one application. I mean, how many number of reports we can generate from a single application?
Any number of reports that you want. So, there is no limit from Click as to how many reports you can generate from a single application. It only depends on the amount of users that you have and the amount of formats that you are working on currently.
But what about the size? Vijendra.
So if Google has a limit of 25 MBs on the email, then you will have to stay within 25 MBs if you are sending the report on the email. But if you are distributing the report to a specific location on a specific server, then there is not a upper limit to the size of the report that you are publishing. So if we are taking it within the constraint of your email provider, then yes, there is a constraint on the size. But if you are publishing report somewhere else, then there is no constraint.
Fine. Thank you.
So, thank you. Thank you, Vijay. I hope you got your answer. Sachin Kare has a question. Can we send text message of any KPI on mobile number of user through Emprinting?
No. We do not have SMS feature in Emprinting yet. But you can send a small email. Just a text email with every number in the body, if that helps.
Okay.
Without any, you know, without any attachment to the email, you can do it.
Okay.
Okay. Thank you, Abhishek. I hope Sachin, you got your answer. Rahul Agarwal has a question. Is there any interface which is accessible to business user?
So, in the previous versions, we had no such interface which was accessible to the users. But now with Emprinting 17, you have seen Newsstand that is accessible to the user. He can log in and get the reports from there. So it is one of the places he can get reports from. And through on-demand feature, you can go to a particular dashboard that has enabled the on-demand Emprinting feature. and then you can just click on the on-demand button. You will get that report sent to your email there and then. So these are some of the ways you can interact with imprinting from a user's perspective.
Yeah, thank you, Abhishek. Agarwal, hope you have got your answer. Okay, anybody else have some queries, answers, questions, anything? Okay, thank you. Abhishek, go ahead.
Okay, ma'am. So now I will be talking about the implementation of imprinting at one of the big fours. What drived this change and why was it required?
Hey guys, some music is coming. Can somebody on mute?
Okay, so here is the pre-imprinting scenario. So it is a very big organization and we already had given 600 user calcs for people to get into ClickView, analyze data, get their reports and send it across the organization. But the organization had 14,000 plus people and doing all the reporting through only these people was really a big challenge. And you can imagine the server and the license cost that would have been there if, you know, we would have set out to serve all these people through the dashboards. And obviously client will not be willing to, you know, invest such a huge amount of money in the beginning of a project, right? So that is why we propose that, okay, all of your passive users who are not the part of your core can have all the reports delivered through imprinting. And these are really polished reports and very specific reports that we are sending there. So some of the reports that we are doing there are utilization report for each employee, and we are keeping their managers in CC. So the manager knows how my employee is performing. He knows where are his hours going. He knows all the projects that his subordinate is working on. So this goes out every week, and there is a comparison between budget and his actual numbers. So it is like a small report card for him. And secondly, we have weekly performance report for all managers and partners. So in this, if you are going out bringing in business for the company, you'll need to know all your vitals, your revenue, your who are my debtors, where is my WIP standing? Okay, what are my DSO days? How many hours are my employees, you know, punching in the system? And how much revenue am I accruing? So a manager and a partner needs to know all these details. And there are 4,000 people who fall in manager and partner band in this organization. And we could not give access to the dashboard to all these 4,000 people. So getting them these reports weekly is really crucial. And believe me, whenever, even if there is 1 week miss of any report due to a technical issue, or maybe there is monthly closing going on, we get hundreds of mails for asking for reports. So people really take their reports seriously, because it is the only way they can, it is the only and the easiest way they can get their reports, and they have huge trust on the system, and the numbers are never wrong. So if you will build the dashboards correctly and configure the imprinting correctly, you will never get your numbers wrong. So you will have to be confident about the product, and users really appreciate the length of to which you are going for them in creating the specified reports and triggering it on time. It saves them a lot of time and money for the same process. Thirdly, there are some KPI reports which are being sent to the BU head. So these are financial report cards that every business unit head is getting weekly and monthly, depending on the type of report he wants. And fourthly, there is headcount and utilization data that the HR uses. So these are just some of the reports. We have also embedded a lot of data into the email body of the users to prompt them to download the report and be the part of the data journey of the organization. Now, talking about the typical steps that you will go through whenever you go out, you set out to implement imprinting at a client. So first and foremost, you'll have to start gathering the requirement of the client. You'll have to make pointers. You should know what KPI we want.
Abhishek, sorry to interrupt you. So yes. Is there any question on pre-imprinting scenario at a customer? Anything you would like to know on this case study? Pre-imprinting scenario is a very important concept to know. So in which case imprinting is required is what Abhishek has explained.
So guys, if there is any question in your mind, you can ask me right now, or you can ping me. I will answer your questions post the presentation as well. But one thing is there is nothing like a stupid question. If there is a question in your mind, believe me, 10 other people will have that question in their mind, but they are not asking it. So you can just go ahead and ask me the question. Nothing? Chalo, let's move on.
So this is a complete scenario of imprinting need.
So coming on to the steps that you will require. So the importance of requirement gathering is, if you do it correctly, then a lot of to and fro between you and the client is saved. A lot of version development between you and the client, you know, asking for add-ons is saved. If you know what are the right questions to ask, and if the client is clear about what he wants, then a lot of time is saved during the development phase and the UAT phase of the project. So whenever going for the data, you should know the granularity, the reports required, and who will be my recipients for these reports. So this is the basic requirement. Then secondly, you will sit with the customer, finalize the formats for the report. He might want some PPTs, some Excels, some Word documents or some PDFs. So the user should be clear that what reports he want and in which formats. So coming on to the development of Qlik dashboard. So if the Qlik is not already implemented at the client and we are moving with a solution, then you might have to build the Qlik dashboard from scratch. But if the user is a matured one and you already have your Qlik deployed there, then you can use the pre-existing dashboards or tweak the pre-existing dashboards to match the imprinting requirement. Then fourth step is, now that you know all the customer requires and you have developed the dashboards and the data is ready and tested, you just need to go out, open your imprinting designer and start building your reports. And the final step is to configure the data. Now, as the imprinting administrator, it is your job to see that the right report goes out at the right time and to the right user. So there are plenty of options to configure the timing issue. There are plenty of options to configure the filters, and there are plenty of options to configure the recipients. You can add CC, BCC, you can add dynamic CC, dynamic BCC, according to the requirement. So one more thing, before you send out any emailers, you should test it with a smaller data set, so that you know that your report is going out fine, all the numbers, all the filters that you have set up are taking into account. So you can just configure your email ID or a few of your email ID from your team, set it to certain amounts of data where you are filtering all of the data, and send these emailers to yourself to just have a check before, you know, actually handing out the data to the users. This saves a lot of escalation. This saves a lot of time in reconfiguring, and the whole process goes smoothly. Now, talking about the value addition that was brought to the customer. So the user base for your informed decisions was really expanded from 600 to 14,000 plus. And we were sending out reports to the external vendors as well, wherever external clients as well. So if the company has some debtor, so we are sending a report to a debtor, look, this much amount is pending on you, please pay us. So a lot of manual task is saved here. And because these emailers are auto-generated, they are always on time. We have set a frequency for each debtor. Okay, we'll send out reminders for 7 days, 14 days, 21 days, and 28 days. So this helps bring the overall debtor days down, and the cash flow increases. It speeds up. So this is a very good takeaway from Inprinting that you can implement at your client as well to bring down the debtor days, because everybody wants money fast. And regular reminders, automated reminders help in achieving that. So these reports are the backbone of the data for more than 3,000 managers and 400 partners. And I have already talked about the follow-ups. Utilization reports showcase chargeable hours booked, helping the resource to manage and meet expectations of their managers. And this really helps them during their promotion process as well. So their billing collection multipliers, etc., are calculated through their chargeable hours. So it is very important for them. So coming on to the further sessions that we have planned. So first of all, any questions from this case that we have just discussed?
Yeah, so Shashank Koth has a question.
Yes.
Abhishek. So he's asking, can you tell me requirement for Inprinting installation?
Yes. So the next session that we have planned is on Inprinting installation. So you will be guided through each and every step that you require to install Inprinting on a server or your system at the client place. So if you will go through that, you will be able to install Inprinting server basically anywhere. So you just need to be patient for that.
Okay. Thanks. Shashank, you got your answer?
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Rohit Gupta, is there any limit to the pages we add to a report? He's asking. Rohit Gupta is asking,
so,
is there any limit to the pages?
So, Rohit, if you're sending the report on email, yes, the report size should be within the limits of the email service provider. But if you're sending it on some directory, on some predefined paths on the server, then you can just go ahead with it.
Okay, sir. One more thing. If we add multiple pages to the report, will it make slow? Will it make the editing slow?
So editing will not be slow, but the deployment will be slow.
Okay. Thank you.
Whenever you are generating a lengthy report, so the system has to apply the filter in the dashboard. Then it starts the extraction. Okay. So whenever you are extracting a heavy report from ClickView, you see that it takes 5, 10, 20 minutes to get the numbers out whenever you export to Excel. Okay. So
yes,
the same amount of time is taken by Click Inprinting as well, because it is just automating those processes that are built within Click. So it is just sending that data out, keeping it in a temporary folder, and then sending out the emailer. So yeah, that process will take time if the data is built.
Okay, thank you, Abhishek. So next question from Vanshika Rastogi. She's asking, once you create a report, is there any limitations to send it to the users? I mean, the yes. number of users?
Yes, yes, there is a limitation. So in previous versions, we had more or less 7,000 to 8,000 users at a time. And now I guess you have to configure it while buying the product on as to how many users can simultaneously get the report.
Okay, thank you. Thanks, Abhishek. So,
ma'am, one second. So Abhishek, as you are saying, that customer has to it has to be pre-decided. What if the customer again after implementing it for some say 1,000 users, then he again says, no, this is a very good tool, I want to increase my users, then what is to be done?
Then you can just upgrade it.
Okay,
if the customer is ready, why not upgrade it?
So it meaning that they have to buy more licenses, something like that?
So I have been working on mostly the version that I haven't, you know, really got the opportunity to upgrade it, because okay. I already have access to 7,000 to 8,000 users parallelly.
Right.
So I do not have the opportunity to upgrade it, but I will get back to you with this.
Sure.
I will get back to you.
Sure.
Hi, ma'am. Sorry, ma'am. Just like.
Yeah.
And actually, we have no for user. We have no not heard from any client or from the scenario where we have a limitation for send recipient. How many users we can send email?
Okay. I just wanted to know, like, maybe some user would be like, no, let's do it for, let's say, for 1,000 customers, if it 1,000 users, if it works fine, then we would like to upgrade it. So in that scenario, I was asking if we have done anything like this before or not.
Yes, or
no. Okay.
Okay. Thank you, Sonam. Okay. Thank you, Krishna. So next question. Question from Anubhav Gupta. Can we use nprinting only in ClickSense desktop or it all ClickSense server? So he maybe wants to ask whether nprinting can be used in ClickSense desktop or ClickSense server would be required. I mean, this is what he wants to ask. Anubhav, am I right?
Ma'am.
Yeah, Anubhav, can you repeat your question? What do you want to ask?
So, I'm asking that question, can we use the nprinting on the ClickSense server?
Krishna, are you taking up this question?
Okay. So Anubhav, we need a ClickSense Enterprise version for nprinting connection. We cannot use ClickSense desktop.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay, Abhishek, continue.
Ma'am, any more questions?
No, thank you. Abhishek, please go ahead.
Okay. So, in the final part of this presentation, I'll just tell you about the further classroom sessions that we have planned for you. So, the next session will be on nprinting installation. So, you will get to know all about the installations and making the connection to the already existing ClickView or ClickSense that you have in your system. And the second session will be very important, because you will be getting to know how to build the reports and how to actually go about it. You have variables in your Click dashboards, right? You have pivot tables, you have images, you have chart. So how to put everything together within a single report is the crux of class 2 that we have planned. And we will be giving you insights about how to go about Excel, Word, PPT, HTML, and Pixel Perfect reports. The third session is purely based on the administrative point of view on how to schedule tasks, insert recipients, apply all the kinds of filters to generate the specific report for specific users. Okay. And the last classroom session in this series will be to set up the on-demand imprinting. So with on-demand imprinting, you can simply click on an on-demand imprinting enabled dashboard and get your data sent to your email. So it is a very nice feature to have. So many of the clients use it. So it will be covered in this series as well. So any question? Any feedback from you guys?
Yeah, Abhishek, I want to know your users been expanded to something 14,000, right? So what is for your task, like how much it takes?
So the user base is currently more than 14,000. So what we are doing is we because when you are setting out and sending one report to 14,000 users, it will take a lot of time. And in the middle of the process, if the server fails, if anything moves wrong, then you will have to start again from the scratch. So
yes,
to combat this, we have broken them down on the basis of the business that they are serving within the organization. So we have primarily broken them down into four groups. So around 5,000 users are getting reports from one task.
Mm-hmm.
So that even if the task fails, I'll have to reschedule it for only those 5,000 people. And
okay, so you are running the task parallelly, like 5 subset.
Subset of 5, not parallelly. We are doing it serially. When okay. One task completes, the second task starts. Like that.
Okay. Fine. Hi, Abhishek.
Hi.
So I want to ask, like, when we are installing Click Imprinting on a server, Click Imprinting and the Click Sense, we have to install it on separate server. I guess it's correct. Yes.
No, you can have it on same server as well.
We can have it on same server.
Yes, you can have it on same server as well.
Okay. Thank you.
Anybody else? Any question? Any query you have?
Hello, Abhishek.
Yes.
Does imprinting require single server to execute all tasks, or it will require multiple server?
In majorly all the scenarios that you will face, you will be working on a single server for the imprinting. Hmm. Because, but you can, like I told in the presentation, for the multi-threaded and parallel load running, you can break it, but there is no requirement from imprinting's perspective to break it unless the set is really, really large. But that can be combated through a better server. So you won't find any need for that.
Thank you.
Yeah. Hi, Abhishek. Vijendra.
Hi.
Yeah. Can we add a date, like date variable or like the moving date in a subject line?
Yes, you can. Right now, what we are doing is whenever we send out the emailer to the user, we are saying that utilization report till this date. So that date is variable, so that user has a different, user can filter out that report within the inbox.
Yeah. So means like in subject line only, no? I will get like today's date. So the report is for today's date.
Yes, you can get it in subject line, body, wherever you want.
Yeah. Thank you. So can you show means like how we can implement that or?
So that will be covered in the third session.
Okay.
Thank you, Abhishek.
Is that it? Deepti ma'am?
Yeah, thank you, Abhishek. Thank you, all of you. Please, you can be in touch with Abhishek, Jen, and also Krishna, who have got enough experience in imprinting. And we are very soon going to schedule session on the installation part and further on report sharing. Thank you very much. And hope that you all will be attending the tomorrow session. Thank you, Abhishek. It was a wonderful session.
Thank you, everyone. Special thanks to Krishna and Deepti ma'am for helping me out arrange this session. And everybody, you can, you know, just ping me your queries or mail me your queries. I will answer your queries whenever I get time. Okay. So it is an open channel. It's a two-way stream. Your queries are always welcome.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.